My name is Heidi Huisman. I live here in Dyersville, but I am originally from the suburbs of Chicago. My dad was a garbage man, so picking was always in my blood. We always got our stuff from the curb. When I moved here to Dyersville, I had a booth over at the antique mall here in town. And a couple years ago, my friend asked if we wanted to open a little shop just for the toy show. So we rented this storefront. She left after the 2 weeks, and I've been here ever since. We are located on historic Route 20 here in Dyersville. It goes all the way from Boston, Massachusetts to Newport, Oregon. This is my personal collection of Chinese checkerboards. I've collected them for years. I don't even know how to play. I love all of the colors. I don't have any of them that are the same. But since I've moved upstairs, I really don't have a wall for them. So now they're for sale here in the store. So I like small things. I'm happier with a shoebox full of Cracker Jack toys than I am a big piece of furniture. I do sell a lot of kitchenware. That's one of the things that I like the most. So bowls, utensils. I think it's made better than the newer Tupperware, and it's pretty cheap and very usable, very functional. And then this whole wall, if anything describes me, it's this wall over here. It's all of the smalls. I have it organized by color because I'm crazy obsessive like that. Everybody always says reduce, reuse, recycle, keeping things out of the landfill. But there's just the quality of vintage goods is so much better. Furniture is made of real wood, glass. You know, I love that people have learned how to make kitchen bowls and things like that using recycled glass, but they also don't last as long. It's still the quality of vintage goods holds the test of time. I've expanded the shop to not only have vintage or antique stuff, but I have a lot of locally made and other local business people have their stuff in here. 2015, I added the bird's nest. She does painted and hand-built barnwood furniture. So these are some of her pieces here. Her new thing over here, she does these dream players, folk art. She's been selling a lot of them because where the Field of Dreams is here in Dyersville. So she does custom designs, and she donates $5 of every piece to the Field of Big Dreams, which is Frank Thomas, the owner of the Field of Dreams. That's his charity. The store is all stuff that I like and hope other people like too. Even if I don't decide to keep it a vintage antique store, you know, I have local artisans, local art. One of my goals is in the basement to have an art gallery, kind of like a speakeasy style. So, you know, as long as I can get up 22 steps and live upstairs, I'll probably still be here.